Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. In today's video, I'll show you how to install Chrome OS with full Google Play Store support on a USB drive using a Windows PC. This allows you to run Chrome OS on any computer without installing it to your hard drive. So without wasting any more time, let's jump right in. First, you should download Chrome OS recovery file that matches your current CPU architecture. For example, I'm currently running an AMD processor, so I will be using Gumbos, but if you're running an Intel processor, you can use Shivana for 8th and 9th generation, Jinlun for 10th generation, and for 11th generation or higher, Voxel. Now, in order to download the latest build, what you have to do is visit a website. So open your Google Chrome, go to Start Menu, search for Chrome, and go to a website called CrossTech. Enter. Now we simply select the code name that I just told you. So as I am currently using AMD, I will be using Bumbuzz. So now over here, just use the code names that I told you. Like for example, if you're running Intel 8th or 9th gen, you have to use Shivana, which is going to be Shivana. This is the code name. All you have to do is just click on it. Then if you are running 10th gen, that will be J-I-N-L-O-N. And over here, you'll be able to see the code name. And for 11th gen and above, you will be using Voxel, so V-O-X-E-L, as you can see right over here. And in my case, for AMD users, it is going to be Gumbos. So Gumbos, as you can see right over here. Now click on it, and now just download the latest version. So just scroll down and click on Recovery Images and choose the latest version, which is 133 right now. Now the download will begin, as you can see, right over here. Now once the download is complete, next what you have to do is you have to go back to Google Chrome and visit a website of Brunch GitHub. So open the first option in your Google Chrome. Now just simply get the latest model, so what you have to do is click on Brunch Release right over here. Now just simply download the main file over here and wait for the download to complete. As you can see, the download has begun now. While it is downloading, create a new folder on your desktop. Now go to the downloads where you downloaded Chrome OS and transfer it to the new folder that you've created on your desktop. Now wait for the Brunch file to complete downloading as it is about to finish. The next thing that you have to do is go back to your download menu and transfer the files into the new folder that you just created. So just simply drag and drop like this. Now you can close this window and open the new folder. And now just simply extract both the files in the same folder. So click on Extract All, or you can use any other method to extract the files. Now wait for the extraction process to complete. So the reason we are using the Brunch framework is because it lets you install Chrome OS on non-Chromebook devices like Windows or even USB. So wait for the extraction to complete. Now once the extraction process is complete, create a new folder in the same folder and name it Chrome OS. Now go inside the extracted folder and copy all the data and paste it inside the Chrome OS folder that you just created. Rename the recovery file to Chrome OS Recovery for clarity. Since the Brunch framework and its installation script are designed to run on Linux, what you have to do is for the Windows users, you have to set up a Linux environment using Windows Subsystem for Linux option. To do this, open your Windows feature, go to the Start menu, and type Turn Windows Features On and Off, as you can see right over here. In the Turn Windows Features On and Off page, look for Subsystem for Linux, as you can see right over here. Simply check this box, and once you do this, Windows will start downloading a few files. After that, it'll ask you to restart your computer. Restart it. And once the restart process is complete, next you have to install a Linux distribution like Ubuntu. Go to your Microsoft Store. Just simply look for Ubuntu, search for it right over here, and then hit Enter. Now just simply install the latest version. As you can see, I have already installed it. Now just simply open it, click on Open. Now, once you open your window for the very first time, it might ask you to create a username and password. So just simply complete the process and then you'll be able to enter Ubuntu's mainframe. Now, once you've completed the entire process, you should be in the Ubuntu terminal and it should look something like this, where your username will be shown. Simply enter the command that's given in the description box below this one. If you want to copy, you can do it right over here. The moment you enter this command, hit enter. This will download the necessary file for the Brunch framework. It might take some time to download all the things, so be patient and wait for it to complete. Once that is done, the next thing you have to do is navigate to the Chrome OS folder that you've created on your desktop. Open the Chrome OS folder and copy the entire thing over here. Before that, simply enter this command sed/mnt/det, then copy the folder URL over here and paste it right over here. If you get some type of error like this, as you can see right over here, you will have to remove the semicolons. As you can see, they are all in /, convert them to /, or just simply type the entire thing. Once you do that, just simply hit enter and also make sure to write every single one of them in small letters, as you can see right over here. Once you've corrected everything, hit enter. Now, as you can see, there was an issue. As the bracket will not be recognized if your folder name is nofolder2, try to change it as I changed it to OS. Once you do that, it'll be recognized as you can see right over here. Now, once the path is recognized, enter this command. Now, this will create the Chrome OS disk image file. After pasting the command, hit enter. This will start creating the partition and it'll take a lot of time. For example, depending on your system, it'll take approximately 15 to 30 minutes to complete the entire process, so just simply wait for it to complete. There's one more change that you should do if you're facing issues. Go into the OS folder and in the Chrome folder, just remove Chrome Recovery and make it just simple Chrome in all small letters, as you can see right over here. So if you face an issue, make sure to do this. Now, once it is finished, just simply press enter and then just simply exit the terminal. Now, the ChromeOS disk image will be saved in your ChromeOS folder that you created, which you can see right over here. Now, once you have the disk image, the next thing that we have to do is you have to create a bootable USB. So for doing that, we will be downloading an application called Rufus. So just simply open Google Chrome and type in Rufus. Now open the first option and then simply scroll down and click on the download option right over here. So we will be downloading for Windows 64, so choose that option now. After that, the downloading will begin. Now open the application directly from the download folder and now wait for a few seconds. Now once the application is running, it should automatically detect your USB drive, which you can see right over here, 32 GB. Then the next thing that you have to do is you have to select your bootable image. So what you have to do is click on the select option right over here, then browse to the location of your bootable OS, which is going to be in the ChromeOS folder. So open that and open the ChromeOS folder. Make sure it is going to be a big file. So 14 GB as you can see right over here. Choose that file, then click on open. Now it should select Chroma's IMG. Now once you've done all of that, all you have to do is click on start to flash Chrome OS image on your USB drive. So if something like this appears in front of you, just simply click on yes, and the writing should start, as you can see right over here. So it'll take some time depending on the size of the disk image, which is going to be 14 GB in this case. So it is going to take some significant time. So just simply wait for it to complete. Now once Rufus is finished, just simply click on close, then eject your pen drive. So go to the This PC option and eject your pen drive. Once I've done that, most of the work is done and now you're ready to boot with your Chrome OS. But before that, make sure that you disable your secure boot. You have to go to your BIOS settings. Now the key for entering your BIOS menu could be anything like F2, F8, or F12. It'll depend completely on the manufacturer of your motherboard. So the menu will look something like this. Here you'll find the option called secure boot. Make sure to disable that and then boot from your USB device. So after the customization process, you will see the initial Chrome OS startup screen. Then just simply follow the on-screen instructions, connect to Wi-Fi, log into your Google account, and access your Google services, including Play Store. This gives you full access to Android apps, just like a Chromebook. Now there is a thing that you should keep in mind. By default, your USB drive might not use its full storage capacity. So to fix that, just press Ctrl, Alt, and F2 on your keyboard, and a terminal will open in your Chrome OS. Then log in as the root user, then type a command, which is going to be resize_data. This command will expand the data partition to use the full capacity of your USB drive. So wait a few minutes for the process to complete, then press Enter, then reboot your system. And that's it. You have successfully installed Chrome OS on a USB drive with full Google Play Store support. You can now plug this USB into any compatible computer and run Chrome OS without installing it onto a hard drive. Your apps, settings, and data will all be preserved. So if you found this video helpful, please give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe to the channel for more helpful videos. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.